there, Derek here from Pacific Coast Auto, and here in USS Tokyo. This section of the auction here is all manual transmission cars. So this is the fun section. This is the section where everybody wants to visit because it's full of all the cars that we want to drive. So we're just going to take a look at these cars very briefly, each one. Like this black Lancer Evolution 4 with the TE37 wheels on it and painted black calipers, which is good because usually the red turns into pink over the years and starts to look awful. Evo 4s are a really good price for the, I guess, the value, but they are getting old now. Aftermarket headlights on it. GDB Impreza. My favorite Impreza of all of them, by the way. S15 here with the same wheels as my car. Yay! And widened fenders on the front and on the rear. Eyelids on it. Overall, doesn't look like it's in very good condition. Another GDB here. This one's really neat. Wonder if this one's been converted over to a manual transmission. Yeah, 5-speed. This is a Nissan Gloria. It's got a 3-liter engine in it. Really cool looks to that one with that really boxy fiberglass bumper. Dished in wheels, side skirts. Not something you see every day. Here we have a cool purple R34 GTR. Lancer Evolution 5. EK9 Civic, which are pretty expensive. Good ones are 600,000 yen. Something boring with my wheels again. Really bad condition MR2 here. Peeling paint, it looks like. Not very nice wheels. FRS, which are everywhere in Japan. FRS, it's called the 86 here. DC2 Integra. This is the early model with the 5-bolt wheels. 400,000 yen or so for them. Another S15 here. GTR 32. Really hard car to buy these days because prices are going up like crazy. Even the ones that can't be imported into the US. S15 here. Got some Speedstar wheels. Aftermarket front bumper. Not a nice aftermarket front bumper in my opinion. Now you can open up the cars and take them. Can't take them for a drive. But it would take me forever to do that for all of these cars because there are just so many of them. RX-8 with actually a really nice paint job. You won't be able to see that in the video, I don't think. Oh, gotta show you this, Subaru Leon. Something like this is really, really uncommon here in Japan. First time to ever see a Leon here. Reminds me of my childhood. V30 Turbo. So that's Fair Lady engine. 180SX. Everybody loves those. I get requests for those from a lot of my US customers. You can import them right now, but as of this video, only the CA18 engined versions are importable. And this one has extra ventilation in the front. R32 GTR. R32 GTR. Now, the problem with buying these is the price and the fact that they are rusty. And the engines are race car engines, and so they don't really last forever. There is some confusion over the RB26 engine because everyone says they're overbuilt. That doesn't mean that they're reliable. That just means that they can handle a lot of power on stock internals, which is true. Altezza RS200. Sorry about the wind today. It's like super windy today. What is this? A CLC? I don't know. Maybe in post-production I'll tell you the chassis number of that. I don't know. It's a Civic Type R of some sort. MRS, which I'd like to try driving sometime. MR2, which is another car I've never driven, but I'd love to. Lancer Evolution 4, silver one. Probably sell for about 400,000 yen. The Big Daddy Supra, which I get a lot of people asking me. I don't know what's up with this, but it's basic information that your car has to be 25 years old in order to import it to the US. It should be something everyone will know because you can find that out in about 10 seconds on Google. But this car, more than any other car, I get people from the US basically yelling at me saying, why can't you get me this car? It's my fault. So, sorry you can't, not until it's 25 years old, and they first started in 1993, and so, not for another 3 years from the date of this video. This one doesn't look like it's in really great condition, but it looks like it was once a pretty interesting car. R33 GTST, these are about $4,000 right now. This is not the GTR. Wheels are nice on it. More Evo, it's on RPS1 wheels, which are a great wheel. Very lightweight, very cheap. 180SX, which are everywhere. They have made them until 1999 here in Japan, which is pretty wild. Ugly three-spoke wheels. NC Corolla, what's that doing here? Is that manual transmission Corolla? Yes, it is. Did not even know you could buy those here. Mark II, late model, on ABS model 7 wheels. One of my favorite wheels, actually. More Altezza action. Pink car action. This is Mark II. And it's on GTR wheels, which is awesome to see a fast Toyota on fast Nissan wheels. They fit really well on the JZX chassis. Pink car? Well, it's actually pretty common here in Japan. It's weird. More Corolla. Altezza. Altezza's come with a 6-speed manual transmission and the Beams 2-liter 3S engine. We already kind of looked at that car. Soarer, which I love these cars. I love Soarers. This is my kind of car for sure, because I'm an 80s guy. So, really into these cars. They can come with a 7M turbocharged 3-liter Supra engine. They're basically like a restrained Supra. 8.6, everybody loves those. Nobody loves the condition they're in, because they're all pretty much ratty. MR2 with actually really cool side arrow there. Like that. R33 GTR. Yeah. If I were buying a GTR, I'd get a 33 because the price is there. Well, I know a lot of people don't like the 33, but they are less than half the price of the 34s and not less than half of the value. The performance, pretty much the same. This one's got a funny wheel in the front. I wonder why they got that turned. Accord Euro R. We got more Mark II over here. We got a very nice, shiny looking FD. And next to another FD. Cool. So FD on BBS RGs. Shiny and nice, more FD. They're all over the place here in Japan, and they are pretty cheap, but they're unreliable. And so when you buy them, you gotta expect that the engine's going to explode on you. Impreza. Lancer Evo 7 or 8. 8, I think. I don't know these ones yet, because I don't sell them a lot. Okay, Integra Type R, Skyline R31, which is, you know, when I first started exporting, I wasn't into these cars very much, but the more time goes by, the more I'm getting into them. I think that they're a really lovely, boxy 80s design. They got a great engine. The chassis is fun and 80s style noodly. What do we got? That one's just a Skyline. It's just a Skyline. It's got GTR wing on the back. S15. This S15 seems to have a really... Oh, these old style Volk wheels in good condition are hard to find. Nice spoiler on the back there. Some Impreza, some Fair Lady. This one's probably pretty cheap. The this style. I haven't seen, well, I've never bought one, but oh, yellow headlights. That's neat. Alteza 86. Nice looking RX-7 here. Bugeye Impreza. Not so Bugeye Impreza. GTR with one of the world's ugliest rear spoilers on it and raised suspension. Check that out. Weird, it's got this flap on the back. Looks very much like something you would see in the 90s. Fair Lady convertible, non-GTR R34, Supra,
with tires on the back.
Sweet! It's Mighty Car Mods, but they put the letters in the wrong order. Seeing these really old Lancers, the turbo ones, is quite uncommon. This is before the Lancer evolutions. Mark IV Supra, stock wheels, Chaser, which is awesome. 180SX. GTR. 11. This is an interesting one. This is AE101. Black top, 5 valve per cylinder. 1.6 liter engine that puts out about 175 PS. Don't worry about it.
Is it for US?
No, just because I like taking videos of cars.
But you're from the United States?
No, from Canada.
Oh!
Yes, I think I've met you before at the auction.
Okay. What do you like?
What kind of car do I like? Oh, I don't know. That's a difficult question for me to answer.
Top of your head quickly, the first thing that comes to mind.
Lancia Delta Integrale. But I'm not rich enough to own one yet.
Okay. My favorite car is the arch rival of yours.
I don't know what the arch rival is.
Escort Cosworth RS.
Oh, okay. You see, I'm from Canada. We don't really know about those cars yet. The Evo? This guy's telling me about a car over here. Just let me see. I got the video still running here.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, the Evo 3s are really expensive.
Yeah, but they're gorgeous, aren't they?
Yeah, I don't know.
I like them. I think of Jackie Chan when I see one.
Yeah, so do I, actually.
Yeah. Are you West Coast? Yeah, you're West Coast, huh?
Yes, Vancouver.
Okay. Hope I see you again.
Yes. Good luck at auction today.
Oh, do you live here?
Yes.
Oh. Okay. What's your name?
Derek. I'll shake hands.
TK. All right, sorry to interrupt your video.
That's okay.
Yeah.
86 here. With rotten rear fenders and rotten doors and probably rotten everything else, because these cars are always rotten these days. JZX80 Supra, of course. What do we miss back there? Hood vents on the 180SX. S14 Silvia with the Koki front end. And really interesting wheels. What are those? I don't know. They look cool. AVS, but not an AVS that I'm familiar with. There is something super lucky over here. Check this out. Four-door Skyline. And an R32 that they didn't put the wheels on right. Look at that. C2. R32 GTR, and a Roadster. The NEI Roadsters are a car I'd really like to own too. I'm so glad that they have the pop-up headlights. I can't have that nowadays. Not with so many crazy people running around on the streets. Okay, and the last car is going to be the FD with Model 5 wheels on them. Probably mentioned one of my favorite sets of wheels. Okay, so that's going to be the end of the video. Thank you for watching, and have a good one.